Welcome back to the Bumper Breakfast. So it's an exciting day, and I get to change and wear my jeans.
Baddest.
You know that quote. It was making me feel like
already now you're not looking like a rainbow.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Oh yeah. No.
Oh yeah. 2022.
2022.
Yeah. 2022.
Like, am I?
Because
2022
is too.
There's a pastor on the set.
Apologies, sir.
There's pastor on the set. First thing, good morning.
But is that it?
Austin, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Tony.
We're normal now, sir. Sorry for.
Always be normal.
Austin Adigwe is our last guest for this morning. I want to talk about love. Taking the love of the moment. Taking the love of God into 2022 and doing something differently in 2022. Yeah. You've been talking about love for quite a while. You talk about it in your music and you were talking about it last week with me. And I say, but I can't sorrow love, won't sorrow love. Do you think it's a possibility? Do Nigerians really love each other that much?
Well, it's a possibility, but it must start with the individual. One is not looking at a situation where everybody will embrace love, you know, on a particular second or minute. Let it even start from you. Let it start with you. Because if God says this is the greatest law, greatest, himself telling us that the greatest law is that you love your God, love the God you love with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your mind, with all your soul.
Everything.
And that second to this is you love your neighbor as yourself. That's God speaking, not somebody, it's not a reported speech. So it's not optional. We just have to begin to treat one another with so much consideration, with love. All this tension will calm down. And how do you really say you serve God when you don't love? In the Bible is there that he who does not love does not know God, because God is love. So you can't claim to be a Christian and you don't have love in your heart. The love is not that you should go and start cooking food for everybody. No,
very
that's
charity.
Not it. Just do to others what you love others do to you. As simple, basic. That's just the basic.
But you see,
something
I
just crossed my mind. When I say just do to others things you and do to
like
yourself.
I want to do to you this morning. I expect you to do it back to me.
Well, you've not even done anything. Christmas, not. The cake that we brought here on Jesus' birthday.
It's not me.
The peace of mind she has given to you.
It's not me.
It's not me.
It's the peace of mind.
But I'm a good man. Now, why are you making me sound like on national television that I'm a troublemaker?
I have one. It's funny, right? But you say, do to others what you can do to yourself.
Yes.
How about sometimes you want me to do something for you? That thing that I don't do it for myself. And I'll be like, since I can't do this thing for myself, I'm sorry, I can't do it for you.
For you as well.
You feel I don't love you.
No, you see, like I said, love in this context doesn't necessarily mean that you will become senseless or you become foolish. No.
So you're saying love in the context of maybe we'll do something extra?
Yes. Put others into consideration
when you're doing
every single decision, every single action. Like what I was saying, like a parent who feels somehow overwhelmed by the responsibilities of bringing up a child and decides to go and sell the child for 50,000 naira. So the question is, you ask yourself, if your parent,
so
if your parents are taking that step to sell
you
at your tender, how would you feel? Would that make you happy? If it will not make you happy, then don't even consider it.
That is the point
from where I'm coming from. You know, because the love between a husband and wife is different from the love between siblings. So I don't want us to confuse it. Just go out there and do those things that when people do the same thing to you, you'll be happy.
You wouldn't mind.
But sir, you would agree with me that an average human, they are greedy and selfish to themselves. Just like we have just one food here, a portion of food. And I know you and Tony say you are hungry too, you want to eat. And I'm hungry too, I want to eat. How do you think? And no, it's just a portion for one person.
Well, you see, selfishness is part of human nature. It's not just peculiar to Nigeria, okay? Now, but what is the end game? Mm. That portion of food, you can actually finish it. You end up where? You still end up in the restroom. Is that not awesome? So no matter the portion you take, but if you have genuine love for others, your consideration will be, if I finish this portion of food, Tomisi will have nothing to eat. Austin will have nothing to eat. I'll rather let's have a bit of the portion. You're spreading love.
I'm just speaking from the perspective of human.
You're right.
But you see, it is selfishness that you're talking about.
No. Perspective of human. That's really not. So remember, I said it's not
in people's minds to be selfish or to be loving.
So if the portion was
not like I mean to be selfish.
If the portion was given to Tomisi, would you have loved to have part of it?
The two things are involved. Two things are involved. It's either she share with me, or I understand that is a portion.
Well, you see the problem here. I think it's still selfish.
You're giving me the definition of a portion, right? You're giving me the definition.
But out of that portion, can you just share a spoon?
Now, that is the love we are preaching.
Yes.
Now, that out of that portion, because the love that is
very spread, small portion. I don't think I can share.
What will fill you now? Okay, let me come this way. You know, when I was a bachelor, I didn't really understand the joy of giving. I give, but it didn't really strike me like it's something that could make me happy. And when I became a father, I discovered that if I have 5,000 naira and my baby's diapers is 5,000 naira, I will joyfully buy the diaper and be happy, even though I had nothing left. But seeing him on that diapers and that he's comfortable, he's able to sleep, you know, without any stress, gives me joy. That need that 5,000 would have solved for me has been overtaken by that joy. So when we share genuinely out of love, okay, the need you think you are feeling and that portion will not solve, you'll be shocked that spreading it and just eating in communion will bring more satisfaction than if you are taking the
love. Spreading it, sharing the love, will bring more satisfaction this season. As we enter 2022, the message this morning is share the love. Thank you so much, Austin, for joining us this morning on the Bumper Breakfast. We are around the nerve. And I tell you, my ladies are coming on set right now. That's why I had to change. Want me to be mommy when they are asking. Let's take a break. We'll be back. You'll see all of us. We're cacking. You need to see it. We'll be back shortly.